radish wants to blossom, so I gotta take it. I gotta go through this batch here. There, look at that one. This big old one, it's gonna get tough too. Oh, it's already rotten. Look at it, picked it too late. Well, oh well. I noticed the rodents don't like the smell of rotten brassicas either. That's interesting. So, that one looks like we can leave in there. There's one or two here I'll leave for fresh eating. That's it. So, another backyard harvest. Pretty much the last of the radishes. I got a few small ones left yet to eat for fresh. I'm going to be doing some fermenting today. That's why I'm grabbing the rest of the bulk of them. That's the nightshade family collection there. Cucumbers. Most of the rest of the turnips. The little ones that didn't grow too good. That's okay. Onions. And the morphidite rutabagas. I had to thin them out, so I took all these. They're all, I'm going to do some fermenting, so all this is captured into my ferments. All these stems are in the ferments. That softens them up. And if I mix this with all the other roots that I'm harvesting right now, I think, of course it's just what I think, doesn't mean that's right. I think that the properties of all the different vegetables that I ferment together all mix up. And of course, you know, you eat a little bit of everything every meal, and you get the benefits of the differing elements. All right. Since I put up the higher fence that has no support whatsoever, I haven't had any incidences here of woodchucks eating back the carrots and the beets and the parsnips and everything else I have in here, but I do have evidence that he tried. Right here, I think. He probably got to here, and he didn't like it. So maybe it works. If I didn't have all my trail cameras out in the woods trying to find deer, I probably should stick one here. My ongoing battle with the critters have produced these two bed coverings. The one on the right here is a chicken wire covering, and I actually bent it together at the top and stitched it together with these sticks. So it worked because all these plants now are growing leaves. I did it like 3 weeks ago already. And the real proof is the critters really like these black viper root leaves. And they haven't been touched since I put the chicken wire up. But that tells me this is more of a woodchuck problem than a mouse problem. Because I think the mice can get through those chicken wire holes pretty easily. So now this new arrangement now, I have hardware cloth that's 3 foot, and I'm probably going to put a hardware cloth roof on it. Just right over the top, something that I can take off. But I may leave it like this for a while and see what happens. Then we come over here to see the black viper root plants. See, the leaves are all grazed down. All of them. The parsnip leaves are grazed down. I never had a mouse eat parsnip, so I think that's definitely woodchuck. And it's starting to eat on the beet leaves. I went ahead and made a bunch of harvests out of here because now I have this ground that I can plant a new batch of seeds in. We'll see what happens. I may elect not to put a cover over this. I got to think about it a little bit. Or maybe a chicken wire cover. Because that'll be easy to remove. I got to think about it. But I said I made some harvests out of here. And that's what most of this came out of. Well, not most of it. Maybe half of it. And we have a kohlrabi, tomatoes. This is my first really good heirloom tomato harvest. Onions, beets, apples, those are zestar. These are leeks I'm going to bring over to community garden and plant and see if they grow. Cucumber, I pulled a parsnip out when I pulled the beet out. A celeriac that was in the way of the new fence. And then these are leeks that started going to seed, so they're stiff. And I'm going to cut them up real fine and mix them in with breakfast this morning, which right now is noon. Every Saturday at noon, we get this siren test.